Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. From stories about Mariah Carey to Michelle Williams and many other celebrities, mental health is something that keeps coming up in entertainment news. Our next guest is known as America's Psychologist, and you've also seen him on shows like The Real Housewives of Atlanta and Love and Hip Hop, and he's here to join our discussion about what seems to be going on, or what seems to be going on, in the current celebrity psyche.
Yes.
Hello, Dr. Jeff, how are you?
It's great to be here, Rosanna.
Yes.
Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Who's got it better than me?
I don't know.
Come on, Sister Circle.
Yes.
Powerful, brilliant ladies. Oh, thank
yes.
you so much.
Yes.
Thank
you so much, Dr. Jeff.
We're so very honored to have you here today. Of course, I mentioned that the shows that you've been on. You're the go-to guy, the America's Psychologist. How did you even get into the field? What led you to psychology?
When I was very young, and I know we've been talking about race this morning and the importance of equality, when I was very, very young, as a child, I lived in an all-white neighborhood, and I saw right away that I was being considered and looked at because of the color of my skin and not the content of my character. And even then I knew that this idea of racism and prejudice was a mental illness.
Yes, it is. Oh,
and I
wow.
wanted to start learning what was the dynamic of that and how to begin. I believe we all have a calling from God. And what my calling was to help change people's minds.
Wow. Yeah,
that's good.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think that it's harder for celebrities to deal with mental health issues because of the spotlight, especially because we are constantly ridiculed? You know, everything we wear, everything, you know, we do is just like, it's a problem.
Right.
But we deal with it internally and not going back and forth with these trolls on social media. So do you think it's a little harder for celebrities?
Well, you know, it's really hard to compare when you're looking at someone who has a problem putting food on the table versus one who needs to keep it on the table when we're talking about our celebrities, right? How do you compare that? But that being said, I do believe that there is that extra stressor out there, you know, with all of the haters, with your life being, you know, lived out on the stage. And so that kind of stress, trying to maintain what it is that you have, and of course, being dependent on the adulation of your public, I believe all of those things makes life much more difficult, and therefore that's why I see many of our celebrities are dealing with these mental health issues.
Absolutely. Yes. Speaking of which, Michelle Williams was very vocal about her mental health issues and her depression.
Yes.
along with Mariah Carey, she spoke out about depression as well. Do you think that it is imperative for celebrities to be transparent with these issues or keep it inside?
They have a total responsibility. When you accept that job of being out there in front of millions of people and you become a role model to so many people, whether you want to or not. I know we've had celebrities say, I'm not a role model. Don't put, yes, you are a role model. And therefore, the way that you live your success is the same way that you must live with working out your problems of living to teach people how to deal with their day-to-day issues. That's your responsibility for making all that money.
Much is required.
So, Dr. Jeff, do you think that mental illness is often misrepresented in social media and also in media, period?
You know, I think in many ways that we make fun of people because of the trolls, because of the bullying. We make fun of people who may have some issues, some problems, some sadness, some depression, and there may be some real mental health issues there that we're not really catching. Look, we've seen on social media people who've committed suicide, people who've talked about suicide, and we haven't been able to figure out, wait, that person needs help. So I think it's important that we listen to what's going on and help people instead of bullying them. If they're a little bit different.
Dr. J, why do you think people bully? What does that do for a person who's doing it, who's conducting the bullying sessions? What does that do for them emotionally and mentally? Why are they doing that?
Well, we look at bullies as sometimes being bad people, but as a psychologist, I look at them as people who have their own self-esteem issues. In order to elevate themselves, in order to deal with their own issues, it becomes easier for them to kick someone else. I saw something in social media about a father who confronted a bully who was doing something to his son, and he approached him with love and kindness, and it turned out that boy who was bullying had his own issues, was homeless, so we have to take a look at those things too.
Do you think, before we let you go, do you think there's a sense of denial when it comes to certain celebrities? I posted on my Instagram a picture of me and Kanye from 2014, and I was like, stop laughing, this is a cry for help, and so many people went in on me because I was like, wow, I'm just saying this. So what is it with the disconnect and people seeing something that may be front street
And still not seeing it.
Yeah, when we're dealing with celebrities like that, a lot of people seem to confuse genius for real trouble. Mm. And so many times they also, these celebrities, have these hanger-ons who say, no, it's not a mental health issue. It's that genius that's coming through. You're not really getting it. The fact of the matter is, folks like that, I don't have to mention names because I don't want them sending me anything either. Folks like that really do need attention, they do need help, and I think it really is a crying shame that we let some of our celebrities go out there and make fools of themselves when seriously they do need to get some mental health attention. It's an important thing.
Okay, well, what can the family do? Because when people were trolling me, they were like, this should be such and such job, and as far as people in their family and them going to public places and talking.
Like Kim. Kim right. and his children.
Right, yeah. Right, what can family
members do? Not to mention any names.
Keep it real.
Yeah, but people, what can family members do? Or does it come down to a person like, I'm leaving, I'm going down to the TMZ and I'm talking?
Right, right. I think it's important for us to understand that mental health issues are not, it's not just for the individual. It really does affect the whole family. And that's why we need to support that person who has a mental health challenge. We need to support the family because they do go through the dynamics and the changes themselves. And therefore, it is the village, it is the whole family that must get involved to support that mental health treatment and make sure people stay compliant either on their medications or going to their therapy.
Wow, Dr. Jeff. Thank you so much. You are fantastic. Yes. Open door policy. Please come back.
Yes.
We can talk about some other stuff.
Thank you so very much.
I've been struggling. We all struggle.
Yes,
for more information, make sure you go to Dr. Information on Dr. Jeff. Go to drjeffgardier.com.